If you want a religion as the basis of your political attitudes, if you want something that is you, what you consider to be absolute, or a system of belief, not Tony Blair saying, these are my views, what are yours? Not the views of contemporary politicians. If you want something that's absolute, and as she conceives it, things that people will live and die for, and fight for, in real historical time, you have to have things that are above and beyond man. You have to have things of metaphysical veracity and objectivism. In where theology merges in with philosophy, there's this idea of metaphysical objectivism, truths that are believed to be outside man and are taken as absolutes. The contemporary mind finds a lot of this way of proceeding and looking at things extraordinarily difficult, not just because of the possible political and ideological and social consequences that can emerge from it, but also because of the mindset that it involves. What's the difference between paganism and Christianity? Is it the worship of polytheistic gods? Many pagans actually believe there's one source, and the gods and goddesses are metaphors. Pagans believe everything that exists is divine, in all of the systems. This means that destruction is divine, as well as creation. It also believes that femininity is divine, and therefore there's no problem with the masculine and feminine polarity in all things. There are priests in there, priestesses in these religions, there are goddesses in these religions, because they're half of what it is to be mortal. All humans die, go back into eternity, go back into nature, come again. Everything comes again. If we're evolving, it's very slow. And on the whole, evolution is the advance of a tiny proportion ahead of the others, who can barely keep up. Now, ethically, most pagan systems are very different. Paganism tends to believe in retributive violence. It tends to believe that if you push me, I'll push you back. It tends to believe even in violence and aggression as the forethought before being attacked oneself. It tends to have an honour-based system, whereby morality is perceived hierarchically. So, the more noble you are, the more beautiful you are, the more intelligent you are, the more well-proportioned you are, the more knowledgeable you are, the more courage you have, the more favoured you are by the gods, the higher you are in a particular hierarchy. This, of course, has a converse. This does not mean, in accordance with these very ancient precepts, that the lower elements cast off or done in or massacred or done down. What it means is that there's a hierarchy in all forms, both within an individual, between individuals, between families of individuals, between groups of individuals. The hierarchy is everywhere, and no one's at the top in any one of the myriad hierarchies.
We're hardwired for belief, philosophical and religious, that we have to have it as a species and as a group. Look at the number of people who go completely to pieces when there is nothing outside and beyond them to live for beyond instantaneous things right in front of them.
Increasingly, many individuals in this society do not have an overall or an individual meaning. That's why they live moment to moment and day to day in relation to contingency and consumption. The point of great civilization, as expressed in great art, is to raise people out of that particular trough and get them, if only momentarily, looking upwards towards the sky, looking upwards towards higher forms, looking upwards towards the prospect of archetypal forms, looking upwards towards the religions of the past, the present and the future, looking upwards towards God or the gods, or the idea that they might be there, or the idea that it might be necessary that they're there, even if you don't think that they are.